Welcome back to another episode of Georgia Forages, the digital series. My name is Dr. Lisa Baxter, and I'm your University of Georgia State Forage Extension Specialist. Today, we're going to learn about measuring moisture in hay and baleage. Each step in the harvest of hay and baleage has an optimum range of moisture to protect forage quality, minimize risk of heating, or even ensure good fermentation in the case of baleage production. There are several moisture testers available on the market, but in this video, we're going to discuss the three most common methods that we use in Georgia. The first meter we'll look at is a handheld moisture tester. This meter works better in dry hay since it is most accurate under 30% moisture. Insert the probe into the round side of the bale and push the buttons corresponding to moisture and temperature depending on what you're testing. This meter works by sending an electrical current out of one component and receiving it into the other. The resistance measured from this circuit determines the density of the product, and that number is extrapolated to determine the moisture. It's important to remember that this number is just an estimate of the moisture, so collect multiple readings in each bale to more accurately represent and determine what that moisture is. The second meter you may encounter is a Windrow moisture tester. This meter is suitable for higher moisture forage and is reported to be accurate between about 13 and 70% moisture. Collect loose forage from 15 to 20 locations around the field to fill a 5-gallon bucket. If the forage is already in windrows, be sure to collect forage from several locations within the windrow, since the top will dry faster than the bottom of the row. Once you have the bucket filled, press down the tester firmly and evenly into the forage to obtain an accurate reading. The biggest problem with this meter is that the number can vary by user. Notice how the number changes when less pressure is applied to the meter. Finally, let's talk about how to do a microwave moisture test. A microwave oven is likely the most affordable and accurate way to determine moisture in your forage sample. The only problem with this test is usually the proximity of the microwave to your field where you're going to be baling. So just like with the previous example, collect forage from multiple locations in the field. Once inside, tear or zero out the scale so you're just measuring the weight of the forage and not the plate. Cut the forage samples into a 1 to 2 inch section and mix thoroughly. Next, cover the plate with around 100 grams of forage. Weigh the sample and record the initial weight. Don't forget to fill a coffee mug with water and place it in the microwave to prevent the sample from catching fire. Dry the sample for 1 to 2 minutes for the initial dry down. Remove the sample from the microwave, record the weight, and repeat. Shorten the drying intervals to 20 to 30 seconds as you move closer to the final drying weight. Record the weight and the sample after each run. When the sample weight stops decreasing, calculate how much moisture you have in the forage using the following calculation. Subtract the final dry weight from the initial weight, then divide the answer by the initial weight. Multiply this value by 100 to determine the percent moisture in the forage.